Sa mga nandito na, naintindihan niya yung ating topic under the trend shift, calculation of mean, standard deviation, 1SD, 2SD, ang part kayo nahirapan so that we can do that list while waiting for your classmates. Kung nahihiya kayong magsabi, you can use the chat box. So kung nahihiya magsabi, you can use the chat box. So 38 pa lang, nasan yung iba? Inform Ms. Joella.
Oh, ma'am, okay.
Okay, so nasusundan niyo ba yung lecture natin, dear students? Kung hindi, paki-chat ako muna sa chat box. Magsabi kayo kung meron kayong hindi naiintindihan na part. Okay, so yan, mag-admit lang tayo. Kaya pa? Nasusundan niyo ba?
Kakayanin, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay lang po, ma'am.
Okay,
pero...
Okay, so nasusundan niyo. Okay, sige. Yung mahalaga sa quality control is you should know how to compute. And then after, you should know how to plot the control data in... plot the control data using your Shewhart-Levy-Jennings chart or that chart. And then you should know how to interpret your data using the Westgaard control rules. And last, you should know how to establish your decision whether you are going to accept the run or reject the run. Okay? So, antayin natin yung iba. 40 pa lang yung nandito. So, yun yung gagawin nyo sa Unit 2. Okay, so aside from calculation, you have to create a graph, in particular your SLJ chart or Westgaard control chart, and then you have to apply the multi-rules or the Westgaard rules in interpreting your quality control data. Okay? So nasa na yung iba? Nawala na yung iba? And then, okay, sige. And then, my dear students, kapag okay na kayo, naintindihan nyo naman, you kindly please help other students. Okay na? Help your classmates as well. Okay na? So, pakituruan sila pag in case hindi nila masundan yung ating lecture. Okay? So, I am going to repeat yung ating Westgaard control chart. So, dito tayo nag-stop. Okay na? So, dito tayo nag-stop. So, para at least mas maayos yung flow, I'm going to repeat this. Okay? So, under the Westgaard control chart, okay lang ba kayo? So, ulitin na lang natin.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sige. So, under the Westgaard control chart, okay? So, under here, we have 6 Westgaard multi-rules or 6 Westgaard rules. Ito yung gagamitin natin to decide whether we are going to reject the run or accept the run. Okay? So, number 1 rule is 1-2S. So, you have to go back that the accepted confidence limit in clinical chemistry is 2SD. Positive-negative 2SD. So, 1-2S would mean, 1 here would mean the number of control observation. So, isang basis lang nangyari. Okay na? So, 1 control observation exceeds the mean positive-negative 2SD. So, this is your 2SD. Okay na? Positive 2S. So, outside that, makakakita ka ng isang control observation, isang value. So, sa day 1, makikita mo may isang lumampas sa positive 2SD. So, this is your 1-2S. Isang beses pa lang nangyari. So, that is just a warning. So, warning rule muna siya. So, that is used for screening purposes. Next, we have 1-3S. So, you go back. Kahit hindi mo nakikita yung chart mo, pag 1-3S yun, maihisip mo agad, reject the run. Why? Your decision should be reject the run or run is rejected. Why? Accepted confidence limit, again and again, 2SD. Nasa 3SD na siya. Okay na? So, 1-3S would mean one control observation exceeds the mean positive negative 3SD. Isang result daw ay nag-exceed sa positive negative 3S. So, andito si ating negative 3S, yung one observation natin is has exceeded the negative 3S. So, 1-3S rule. This is associated with random error. So, errors which are due to chance, pwedeng mislabeling, okay na, or temperature of the analyzer. Okay na? And your action, if you can see 1-3S in your chart, is to reject the run. Ma'am, minsan lang naman nangyari eh, kahit na outside 3SD pa yan. Okay na? So pag 1-2S, pwede warning. Sige, okay pa. Pero pag 1-3S na, reject the run. Okay? Reject the run. Next, under 2-2S, we have two control observations. So 2 siya. So dalawang control observations exceed either the mean positive negative 2SD. So, hahanapin mo si positive 2S, negative 2SD. So, makakakita ka sa positive 2SD ng dalawang observations that exceeded the positive 2S. So, this is your 2-2S rule. Two observations that exceeded the positive 2SD. Kung dito naman siya, sa negative 2S, still 2-2S pa rin siya. Okay na? So, this is associated with systematic error and your action should be reject the run or run is rejected. Okay na? So, dalawang basis na yan eh. Kung 1-2S pa yan, okay pa, papalusutin pa natin, warning. Pero pag dalawang basis na outside the 2SD, your decision is to reject the run. Okay? Next, 4-1S. So, 4 consecutive control observations exceeded either the mean positive negative 1SD. So, hanapin mo siya. Mean positive 1S, 2S, 3S. Mean negative 1S, negative 2S, negative 3S. So, maghahanap tayo. Okay na? So, we have here the 4-1S rule. 4 consecutive control observations. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Kung makikita mo, all values exceeded the negative 1SD. So, we have here 4-1S. Ma'am, paano pag dun ako sa kabila? Dun ko nakita sa may positive side. Okay na, sa may positive, outside positive 1S. Okay pa rin, pasok pa rin po sa 4-1S. Okay na, so 4 control observations outside the mean positive negative 1SD. In this case, 4 control observations outside the negative 1SD. The negative 1SD. Okay? So, it is associated with systematic error. Your action or decision is to reject the run. Okay na, reject the run. Next, we have R4S. So, for R4S, the range or difference between the highest and lowest control result within an analytical run exceeds positive 2S or negative 2SD. So, dito maghahanap ka ng magkasunod na control observations that exceeded the positive 2S and the negative 2SD. So, kung ito yung negative 2S mo, outside na siya, negative 2S. And this is your positive 2S, outside din. So, this is your R4S. Okay? So, it allows detection of random error associated with random error. And if you can see R4S in your chart, your decision is to reject the run. Okay? Run is rejected. Next, 10X. So, 10 consecutive control observations are on the same side of the mean. Question, what if ang nakita ko ay 6 na control observations on the same side of the mean? Anong tawag doon? Is it a trend or a shift? Joella, is it a trend or a shift? Or anyone? Trend or shift? Okay, very good. Okay, so shift ang tawag doon. Pag 6 control observations on the same side of the mean, shift. But in this case, you can see 10 control observations on the same side of the mean. We call this 10X. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10X. This is associated with systematic error. And if you can see this in your chart, your decision is to reject the run. Okay? Next, we have the general interpretation of quality control results. So, malapit na tayong matapos. Okay? Second to the last slide. Pero after this, open forum tayo so as I can hear your side as well. Okay? So, we have to go back. So, the acceptable reference limit is set at positive negative 2SD. Ibig sabihin ng positive negative 2SD, 95.4% of your results should fall within the normal curve or should be within the control limits. And the remaining 4.6% should fall outside 2SD. Ibig sabihin that 5% or 4.6% is your allowable analytic error. Okay? So the upper and lower reference limits define a specified percentage, usually 95% of the values or 94.5% of the values. Is it 94.5? We have 95.4% or 95.4% of the values for a certain group of population, hence 5% or 4.6% of the population will fall outside the positive negative 2SD. So there is no such thing as a perfect laboratory result. The 5% or the 4.6% is your allowable analytic error. Okay, so if the results are not within positive negative 2SD confidence limit, run a new set of controls and repeat the specimen testing. Okay, repeat the specimen testing. So, ma'am, question, what will happen if during the day, puro out of control, puro reject the run ang nakikita ko, puro outside the confidence limit, am I going to run the patient samples? No. Okay na, no. Dapat within the confidence limit siya bago ka mag-run ng patient sample. Pag outside yan, kahit maghapon ka pang nag-run ng quality control mo, kung hindi pumapasok, still do not run patient samples. Why? Useless lang yung pag-test mo ng patient samples kasi hindi well-calibrated ang machine mo, hindi na-calibrate ang reagent mo, at may problema rin siguro sa laboratory personnel. Okay na? So you have to make sure that quality control testing be done before patient and sample analysis. Okay, next, we have reference limit, reference interval, or reference value. So this is a value obtained by observation or measurement of a particular type of quantity on the reference individual. It is the usual values for a healthy population that represents 95% of the central tendency. So, in establishing the reference values, so itong figure dito, yung diagram dito, is an example of a reference value. So, we have the test and the reference values. So, in establishing the reference values, they followed the confidence limit which is set at positive negative 2XD. Okay na? So, an example is this table. So, assuming that you want to be tested for blood urea nitrogen, creatinine, potassium, sodium, and others. Okay, so you can see the reference values in the result form because these reference values serve as a guide in the interpretation of results. So this would tell whether the concentration of these analytes in your body are normal or abnormal. Okay, na? So next, we have critical or panic values, a laboratory result that may represent a life-threatening situation that sometimes not readily identified. Okay? So, binigay ko lang definition ng dalawa, but the bulk of our topic under this unit is about quality control. Okay? So, my dear students, this ends the lecture. Kung may problema kayo, kung may questions kayo sa ating lecture for today, kindly please raise them now. Okay na? Para mabalikan natin yung ating topic. Okay. So, may tanong? May tanong kayo? Questions?
Is my question ba?
May tanong ba? Para at least, may tanong ba kayo? Quality control? So we have to go back with our learning outcome. Okay, now we have to go back with our learning outcome. So at the end of this unit, you are expected to understand quality control testing. So quality control testing is done in order to ensure that the laboratory results that you release are accurate and precise or are reliable. Number two, tabulate quality control values and perform basic calculations. So sana natuto kayo kung paano mag-compute ng mean. Or in fact, you know this very well. Alam kung alam niyo na ito dati. Mean, your standard deviation, your coefficient of variation, your variance, the 1SD, 2SD, 3SD. Okay? Next, construct a graphical representation of quality control data. You should know how to create your Sheward-Levy-Jennings chart. Other than that, your Westgaard control chart. Anong pagkakaiba ng Sheward-Levy-Jennings sa Westgaard control chart? So, Sheward-Levy-Jennings, ang kanyang y-axis ay yung control values natin, the concentrations of the analyte. Whereas in your Westgaard control chart, yung x, yung y-axis niya ay yung ating standard scores. We have the negative 1S, negative 2S, negative 3S, mean, positive 1S, positive 2S, and positive 3S. Okay? Next, interpret the quality control data using Westgaard rules. I hope you are now aware on the interpretation of your quality control data using these 6 multi-rules. 1, 2S, 2, 2S, R, 4S, 10X, okay? So yung mga yan, for 1S, okay? And last, what is important is you should know how to establish a decision of whether to accept or reject the run. Okay? So okay na ba? Naintindihan nyo? Malinaw yung lecture natin? Nakasunod ba kayo?
Yes, ma.
Okay, sige. So sabi ni Rupert na nasundan daw. So, Joella, yes. Okay, what about other students?
Ma'am, isa sa
okay, what about other students? Ria, yes?
Oh, isa-send mo pa ba yung PowerPoint?
Ah, sige. Yung PowerPoint, isa-send ko na lang. And then, sa PowerPoint lang, pwede kong isend ha. Kasi yung video, putol-putol siya. So, from Zoom to Google Meet. So, next time, siguro, Google Meet na lang ang gamitin natin.
Sige no? Po, ma'am.
Oo. And then, ano pa? Okay na kayo?
Ma'am, yung pagbasa daw ng requirement.
Ah, okay. So yung ang gagawin nyo ngayon, so tonight siguro I'm going to send yung activity nyo. So ang gagawin nyo sa activity, na-emphasize ko yung kailangan natin sa unit na to. Okay na? So magbibigay ako ng quality control observations or values. So ang gagawin nyo is you are going to compute for the mean, SD, coefficient of variation, variance, 1, 2S, 1SD, 2SD, and 3SD. And then, you're going to create your Sheward-Levy-Jennings chart. And then, you're going to apply the Westgaard rules in establishing your decision of whether to accept or reject the run. Okay na? So, alam kong nasa homeschooling tayo, pwede input nyo lang yung formula, lalabas na, but I would want you to do it manually.
Ma'am?
Okay?
Okay? Paano daw po ipapasok
yes, Ria.
Yung activity 1, ma'am? 1.1.
Ay, activity 1.1. Sige, hindi pa kasi pwedeng lens natin. So, nag-brush ata si lens. So, since meron na kayo, alam kong ready na kayo, so, hawakan nyo muna yan sa inyo muna. And then, pag okay na si lens natin, saka nyo siya i-upload sa lens na lang. Okay? Para hindi doble-doble na mag-send kayo sa email ko, another na naman sa lens. So, isang sendan na lang sa lens. Okay? So, ano pa? So, I hope may natutunan kayo ngayong araw. Okay na? So, sa quality control, kailangan natin yan. So, pag nag-work kayo, you can apply that. Pag nag-intern kayo, still you can apply that. As you are going to do daily running of your quality control materials. Okay? So,